Hello and welcome back for the conclusion of episode 10, Clear and Present Danger. That's Bob. When we left off, it looked as if there might be another showdown between he and Spirit. But Spirit has other things on his mind right now. And it's not fighting with Bob. Spirit is more interested in finding a mate. He moves down the fence to flirt with the female. I believe this is the same little female who's been hanging around the stump that both Spirit and Bob have been calling home. Bob can merely sit back and watch. His status as a subordinate male underneath Spirit dooms his chance at romance for now. Spirit has also hit a snag. Seems the dogs have ended his little romp in the grass with the female. And Leo, so secure in his position as the dominant male, has the luxury of having any of the females he wants. As seen previously, the ladies all fight over him. But can he continue to lead the rest of the competition? The next day, as I step outdoors, I catch a glimpse of a large male Anole. It looks like Leo, but I'm too far away to tell for sure. If it's Leo, looks like he's about to be challenged by Spirit. Yes, that is indeed Spirit. He's matured quickly, and today, he's putting it to the test. The other male, believed to be Leo, has disappeared down behind the window blind. Spirit continues his encroachment into Leo's territory. This is the first time I've seen him over here this far. Surely, Leo will come to defend his territory. Spirit goes on with his raid. But he's soon brought to a stop by the dogs. They're just a little too close for comfort. As you all know by now, dogs, like cats and birds, are enemies. They're natural predators to Anoles and the skinks. But not all dogs are a clear danger when they're in the present company of Anoles. The Anoles are smart, and they soon realize which dogs are more of a threat than others. That's Roxy. She's a very very big dog. As far as the Anoles and I are concerned, Roxy is the gentle giant. Yoshi is in no danger. She can feel safe, basking right here alongside her. He might not realize it, but Ziggy's also safe down on the ladder. Yoshi even feels secure enough to come down and do a little hunting. Wow, with a guard dog like that, I'd feel 10 feet tall and bulletproof if I were an Anole. Now please don't forget, these Anoles and skinks are all wild animals. They choose to live here in the kennels, where food is abundant. There's not much I can do to protect them all from their natural enemies, like the ones who prey on them for food. All I can do is make sure that they have the habitat with plenty of places to hide from their clear and present danger. Sadly, on March 27th, 2008, one of my dogs brought to me the lifeless body of a large male Anole. I don't want you all to hate the dogs, so I'm not going to tell you which one caught him. Here, you're looking at the final resting place of one of the most magnificent and intelligent Anoles I have ever known. Underneath that pine cone, at the end of the boardwalk, resting in peace in one of his most favorite places, I wanted him to be in his home territory for eternity. Leo, he came in like a lion, but I'm sure he didn't go out like a lamb. Leo was not a fighter by nature, but I'm sure he had to have fought for his life with everything he had. It's just, Anoles are delicate creatures, and he was no match for a 50-pound dog. Gone, but never will he be forgotten. Leo will live on in all of our hearts. All of us who loved him will never let his memory die. On that tragic day, not only did I bury a friend, I buried a piece of my heart as well.